the acromioclavicular joint, shoulder separations and other problems, and why you should learn how to fall.
I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, back to talk about one of the most common injuries in all of sports. I've had this injury. They represent almost half of all shoulder injuries in sports. Combat sports are no exception, as can be seen by looking at these shoulders. In this video, we will talk about the anatomy involved, how the injuries occur, what orthopedic surgeons are considering when deciding on treatment, how they are treated, and the expected recovery time. If you've not seen my clavicle fracture video yet, please check that out. Shoulder separations and clavicle fractures are very similar in the effects on the body and the symptoms that people will have. Also, at the end of the clavicle fracture video, I mention learn how to fall. I want to double back on this and point out the importance of knowing how to fall for injury prevention, especially this type of injury. Some martial arts with lots of throwing, like judo, practice falling a lot. Unfortunately, in many combat sports and other sports, and as we age, falling is a neglected skill. Clearly, nothing eliminates all injury risk, especially in combat sports. But a small investment in learning how to fall will pay dividends. So, to review some terminology, shoulder separations, also known as acromioclavicular or AC joint injuries, happen all of the time in sports. It is also worth pointing out that a shoulder separation is very different from a shoulder dislocation, as the injuries are at different joints. The anatomy involved is as follows. The arm moves through the shoulder joint, also known as the glenohumeral joint, which is the connection between the big arm bone, the humerus, and the scapula, or shoulder blade, at a part called the glenoid. We talked about this stuff a bit in my Americana and Kimura videos. When this joint pops out, it is considered a shoulder dislocation. As the arm is moved, the scapula also moves along the rib cage, providing a very important biomechanical link through the glenohumeral joint. The scapula's and arm's only connection to our skeleton is the clavicle. The joint that connects the scapula and the clavicle is the acromioclavicular AC joint. There are other ligaments that connect the scapula to the clavicle called the coracoclavicular or CC ligaments, which support the AC joint and are very much part of the discussion of shoulder separations. The clavicle continues to the rest of the skeleton and attaches to the sternum or breastbone. Injuries at the sternoclavicular joint are rare. For what it's worth, a posterior or backwards dislocation of this joint is a surgical emergency, as the clavicle may be poking into some very important structures. Going back to the connection between the scapula and the clavicle, and how the arm's only connection to the skeleton is through this area. Without these connections, the arm is not supported, and gravity takes it down. The connections in this area create a shoulder suspensory complex, and the AC joint and the CC ligaments are crucial to it working. The AC joint is a true joint with a joint capsule and ligaments supporting it. It also has a cartilaginous disc within it, but this usually breaks down by the age of 40. It is also a very common joint to develop arthritis in. But there are some younger populations, such as heavy weightlifters, who can develop a condition called osteolysis of this joint, which can cause pain and dysfunction relatively early in life. The AC joint ligaments primarily restrain the clavicle from moving forwards and backwards. The CC ligaments primarily restrain the upward or superior motion of the clavicle. There are also big muscles like the trapezius and the deltoid that also help support the AC joint. The AC joint is usually injured from an impact to the shoulder with the arm at the side that forces the acromion and scapula downward. The injury can also sometimes happen with a fall on an outstretched arm that forces the scapula and clavicle in different directions. In very rare circumstances, the clavicle can be pushed backwards or downwards. As force is applied to this area, the AC ligaments will fail first, followed by the CC ligaments. Then the deltoid, trapezial fascia, will fail as the clavicle translates further upward. With disruption of the shoulder suspensory complex, the arm goes downward and the clavicle springs upward, giving us a very distinct look of the shoulder. The distance the clavicle travels upward on X-ray helps orthopedic surgeons determine which tissues are injured. When seeing an orthopedic surgeon, X-rays will be taken. Sometimes a comparison with the other shoulder is necessary. Fortunately, most of these injuries do not require surgery to return to normal function. Grades 1 to 2 never need surgery. Grade 3, there is some debate, but I usually recommend against surgery. Grades 4 through 6 usually require surgery. Fortunately, these injuries are rare. Recovery without surgery usually involves a sling for comfort. It provides support to the suspensory complex that is no longer working well. As pain improves, range of motion is started and progressed as the patient tolerates. Once range of motion is restored, strengthening can begin. Normal function is usually resumed 2 to 3 months after the injury. The specific surgeries for these injuries vary. There are over 60 different surgeries described for this injury, and when there are lots of different surgeries for a problem, that means there is no clear consensus on what the best surgery is. These surgeries include using a plate and screws to hold the clavicle down, as seen here with Alexander Gustafson. The biggest problem with this is that the plate, unlike with clavicle fractures, needs to be removed about 3 months after the surgery, as it will wear away at the acromion over time. Other surgeries reconstruct the CC and or AC ligaments with the person's own tissues or donated tissues and or sutures. Recovery after surgery varies depending on the type of surgery performed and if other surgeries are needed, but often has a similar timeline as non-operative management, so as long as there are no complications. Long-term issues with this injury include a prominent clavicle, development of arthritis within the AC joint, up to 50% of those with this injury develop this, or development of chronic instability of the AC joint. Fortunately, this is very rare. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board-certified orthopedic surgeon, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, shoulder separation survivor. I practice falling. Let's keep moving.